Hello my dear friends, welcome. Now we are going to continue with the chapter 4 in the NCERT textbook class 11, the animal kingdom. Previously we have covered about the plant kingdom, biological classification and the living world. So and if you are thorough with the three chapters, then follow this fourth chapter. Okay, so first we are going to see about animal kingdom. When you look around, you will observe different animals with different structures and forms. As over a million species of animals have been described till now, the need for classification becomes all the more important. The classification also helps in assigning a systematic position to a newly described species, like where we have to keep the species. Basis of classification. In spite of differences in structures and forms of different animals, there are fundamental features common to various individuals in relation to the arrangement of cells, body symmetry, nature of coelom. Coelom means the central cavity, we call it as coelom. Pattern of digestion, circulatory and reproductive systems. These features are used on the basis of animal classification and some of them are discussed here. Let's see the level of organization. Though all members of Animalia are multicellular and eukaryotic, all of them do not exhibit the same pattern of organization of cells. For example, in sponges, the cells are arranged as loosely cells aggregates. That is, they exhibit a cellular level of organization. Some division of labor, like activities, among the cells. In coelenterates, the arrangement of cell is more complex. Here, the cells performing the same function are arranged into tissues. So, in the coelenterates, so we have the tissue level of organization. A still higher level of organization, that is organ level, is exhibited by the members of Platyhelminthes and other higher phyla, where tissues are grouped together to form organs. Each specialized for a particular function in animals like annelids, arthropods, mollusks, echinoderms and chordates. Organs have associated to form a functional system. Each system concerned with specific physiological function. This pattern we call it as organ system level of organization. Organ systems in different groups of animals exhibit various patterns of complexities. For example, the digestive system in Platyhelminthes has only a single opening to the outside of the body that serves as both mouth and anus will be the same for Platyhelminthes. Hence it is incomplete. A complete digestive system has two openings, that is mouth and anus. Similarly, the circulatory system also may be different. So all of them is multicellular, but the level of organization and the tissue level, cellular level, it may differ according that we have grouped the animals. Open type and closed type. Open type, in which the blood is pumped outside the heart and the cells and tissues are bathed in it, that we call it as open type of circulation. So closed type, in which the blood is always circulated through a series of vessels of varying diameters like arteries, veins and capillaries. Always, for example, we humans are closed type of circulation. Always the blood will be flowing inside the blood vessels. We can never see a blood outside the blood vessels. So that we call it as closed type of circulatory system. Symmetry. Animals can be categorized on the basis of their symmetry, means equality. Sponges are mostly as asymmetrical because right and left side will not be the same. That is, any plane that passes through the center does not divide them into equal parts. When any plane passes through the central axis of the body, divides the organism into two identical halves, then we call it as radial symmetry. So, coelenterates, ctenophores and echinoderms have their kind of body plans. So, animals like annelids, arthropods, etc., where the body can be divided into identical left and right halves in only one plane, that exhibit which we call it as bilateral symmetry. So, for example, this picture is a crab. It has only bilateral symmetry. It can divide the body into two equal halves. That too when we cut the body exactly in the center. And here, this is the radial symmetry. So in this radial symmetry, if we cut, it will be like a round cake. If we cut the cake into whatever the plane, you will get an equal halves. So this is radial symmetry. And with only one plane, if you get that, we call it as bilateral symmetry. And showing the germinal layers, we have the three germinal layers. Ectoderm, endoderm, mesoderm. Okay, ectoderm, endoderm and mesoderm. Always on the center. So here we have the gel-like structure or the tissue-like in between the ectoderm and endoderm, which we call it as mesoglia. If the organism is diploblastic, means it has only two germ layers, you will have this mesoglia. If the organism is triploblastic, then we have ectoderm, endoderm and mesoderm. So these are about germinal layers. Those animals in which the developing embryo has a three germinal layers, the mesoderm, in between the ectoderm and endoderm are called triploblastic animals. Example, Platyhelminthes, two chordates are triploblastic. Next, coelom. What is a coelom? So presence or absence of a cavity between the body wall and the gut wall is very important in classification. The body cavity which is lined by mesoderm, we call it as coelom. Here is the picture. We can see this is the coelom, a complete cavity. Animals possessing the coelom, we call it as coelomates. Example, so now we came to know the coelom is present in the mesoderm. Inside the mesoderm, if there is a cavity, then we call it a coelom. If it's present, we call it as coelomates. Example, annelids, mollusk. Annelids means ring, earthworm. Mollusk, arthropods. Or for example, for mollusk, we will get the soft organisms like octopus, mollusk. Arthropods, insects, echinoderms, hemichordates and chordates are the examples for coelomates. In some animals, the body cavity is not lined by mesoderm. Instead, the mesoderm is present in a scattered pouches in between the ectoderm and endoderm. Such body cavity we call it as pseudocoelom. Pseudo means false. It is not a true coelom. So ectoderm and such body cavity we call it as pseudocoelom, and the animals possessing them we call it as pseudocoelomates. Example, Asclepias. So Asclepias, the animals in which the body cavity is absent, we call it as acoelomates. Example, Platyhelminthes. So Platyhelminthes are acoelomates. So diagram. So first diagram is coelomate, coelom, presence of coelom. Second diagram is pseudocoelom, means the coelom is present in a form of pouches, which is incomplete. And finally, we have acoelomates. There is no any body cavity. Let's see the segmentation. In some animals, the body is externally and internally divided into segments with a serial repetition of at least some organs. For example, in earthworm, the body shows this pattern which we call it as metameric segmentation. Metameric means different. Meta means change. So we have different type of ring-like structures. Like it is being separated in a form of that ring-like structures, we call it as segmentation. And another phenomenon we call it as metamerization. Coming to the notochord. The notochord is a mesodermally derived rod-like structure formed on the dorsal side during embryonic development in some animals. So animals with notochord, which we call it as chordates, and those animals which do not form these structures, we call it as non-chordates. Porifera to echinoderms are non-chordates. Okay, so the chordate in future, the notochord in future will develop into vertebral column. Okay, not all chordates are vertebrates, but all vertebrates are chordates. Understand this statement. This is a very important statement. Not all chordates are vertebrates, but all vertebrates are chordates. Classification of animals. The broad classification of animalia based on common fundamental features, as mentioned in the preceding section as below. Let's see the classification. First, kingdom. So it is animalia, which is multicellular. Coming to the level of organization, we have divided into two levels, that is cellular level of organization, tissue, organ and organ system level of organization. Next, coming to the cellular, symmetry, body cavity or coelom. So cellular level of organization is acoelomates and mostly asymmetrical.
Example, porifera, sponges, porifera means pore-bearing organisms, sponges. Next, in the tissue level of organization also, the symmetry is two types, radial and bilateral. Coming to the radial symmetry, again, these are acoelomates. Okay, coelentrata and ctenophora. Okay, coelentrata and ctenophora. Coelentrata, we also call it as cnidaria. And next, bilateral symmetry. Without body cavity, with false coelom and with true coelom. So, without body cavity, it is platyhelminthes. With false coelom, it is asclamenthes. And with true coelom, annelida, arthropoda, mollusca, echinodermata, hemichordata and chordata. So, how to remind this whole flowchart is, for example, phylum. So, the first porifera, we already know. There will be no any coelom or maybe coelom, porifera. And it is asymmetrical. So, cellular level of body organization, this is very easy to know about the sponges. If you remind about the sponges, you will get all these points. Coming to the radial symmetry, which is acoelomate, coelentrata and ctenophora, all will start with C, coelentrata and ctenophora. And next, without body cavity and acoelomates, which is platyhelminthes, already it is flat, then how it gets a body cavity? So, with that, we can remind this. And next, asclamenthes, which means false or pseudo. And next, with true coelom, annelida, arthropoda. Annelida, arthropoda, we will know. In between, you will have the mollusk and echinodermata, hemichordata and chordata. The important characteristic features of different phyla are discussed now. So, if it is plants, we divide the plants as divisions. Okay, we will not tell the word phyla. If it is animal, so we are calling that the kingdom is divided into various phyla. So, members of phylum are commonly known as sponges. First phylum is porifera, means pore-bearing organisms. Members of phylum are commonly known as sponges. They are generally marine. Okay, you can see the sponges in the marine. Previously, using this, normally we use the house sponges, which is synthetic. But previously, the true sponges are only used as sponges for cleaning. And generally marine and mostly asymmetrical animals. These are primitive multicellular animals and have cellular level of organization. Sponges have a water transport or canal system. So water enters through a minute pores, which we call it as ostia, in a body wall into central cavity, which we call it as sporangiocele, from which it will goes out through osculum. So to identify this, there is an experiment also. They will inject the colored water into the sponges. So from the periphery of the body, the colored water will go in and it will come out like a mouth-like part, which we call it as osculum. And the center cavity, we call it as spongocele. This pathway of water transport is helpful in gathering the food, respiratory exchange and removal of waste. Why we call the sponges as cellular level of organization means each and every cell will work for its all the functions, not like a tissue or not like a organ. So because of that, it is cellular level of organization. This pathway of water will transport in helpful for food gathering, respiratory exchange and removal of wastes. Conocytes or collar cells lining the spongocele and the canals, the digestion is intracellular. The body is supported by skeleton made up of spicules or spongin fibers. Sexes are not separate because the sponges are hermaphrodite, which means bisexual in nature. Eggs and sperms are produced by the same individuals. Sponges reproduce asexually by fragmentation and sexually by the formation of gametes. So fertilization is internal and development is indirect, having a larval stage which is morphologically distinct from adult. So the sponges will have the larval stage. So this is the examples for porifera. So first picture is cycon and the second picture is eusporangia. Next third is spongilla. So example for cycon, it is scypha. For spongilla, which has freshwater sponges, and eusporangia, which we also call it as bath sponge. Next, phylum coelentrata. Phylum coelentrata, or we also call it as cnidaria. These are also aquatic, mostly marine, sessile, or free living. Sessile means it will not move or free living. So on one point we forgot, all the sponges are sessile, means it will not move. It will always attach to the substratum. Radially asymmetrical means like a cake. If you cut into whatever the thing, you will get an equal portion. So the name Cnidaria was derived from. So these are the pictures of Cnidaria. So the first one is Aurelia, which is Medusa. So this type of body we call it as Medusa. So this is polyp, adamsia. So this A and B. Nidoblast or nidocytes, which contain stinging capsules or nematocyst presenting on the tentacles of the body. So like jellyfish. So jellyfish will comes under Cnidarians. So nidoblast is used for anchorage, defense and for capturing of the prey. Cnidarians exhibit tissue level of organization and are diploblastic. They have a central gastrovascular cavity with a single opening, mouth on hypostome. Digestion is extracellular and intracellular, both inside the cells and outside the cells. Some of the Cnidarians, example corals, have a skeleton composed of calcium carbonate. Cnidarians will exhibit two basic body forms, example polyp and medusa. The former is a sessile, means polyp is sessile, cylindrical forms like hydra, adamsia, etc. Whereas later it is an umbrella shaped and free living, like Aurelia or jellyfish. So those Cnidarians will exist in both forms, exhibit alternations of the generations, which we call it as metagenesis. Meta means change. That is, polyp produces the medusa asexually and medusa will forms the polyp sexually. Okay, so the example is Obelia. So this is the diagrammatic view of the nidoblast. So this is the nidoblast cell. So because of that, we call it as Cnidarians. Next, phylum Ctenophora. So Ctenophora is commonly known as sea walnuts, comb jellies, are exclusively marine, radially symmetrical, diploblastic, organisms with tissue level of organization. The body bears 8 external rows of ciliated comb-like, which helps in locomotion. Digestion is both extracellular and intracellular. Bioluminescence, the property of living organisms to emit light, that is the characteristic feature of Ctenophora, that is also a very important question, is well marked in Ctenophores. Sexes are not separate. Reproduction takes place only by sexual means. Fertilization is external with indirect development. So indirect development means larval stage will be there. So pleurobrachia and Ctenoplana are the examples for Ctenophora. Next, Platyhelminthes. So this is pleurobrachia. Next, phylum Platyhelminthes. They have dorsoventral flattened body. Hence we call it as flatworms. Platyhelminthes or flatworms. They are mostly endoparasites found in animals, including the human beings. The flatworms are bilaterally symmetrical, triploblastic, acoelomates. Animals with organ level of organization starts with Platyhelminthes. Hooks and suckers are present in the parasitic forms because it has to hold the host. Some of them will absorb the nutrients from the host directly through their body surface. Specialized cells called flame cells helps in osmoregulation and exertion. Sexes are not separate. Fertilization is internal and development is through many larval stages. So some members like Planaria possess a high regeneration capacity. So Planaria is the masters of regeneration. So there is a very, very important question. Planaria is the masters of regeneration. Example, Tinea, tapeworm, or Fasciola or liver fluke. These are the best example for Platyhelminthes. Next, phylum Asclepiomenthes. So the body of Asclepiomenthes is circular in cross section, hence the name round worm. So Platyhelminthes is flat worm, Asclepiomenthes is round worm. So they may be free living, aquatic and terrestrial, or parasitic in plants and animals. Round worms have organ system level of body organization. They are bilaterally symmetrical, triploblastic and pseudocoelomate animals. Elementary canal is complete with well-defined, well-developed muscular pharynx. An excretory tube removes the body waste from the body cavity through excretory pore. Sexes are separate, which are dioecious. That is, males and females are distinct. Often males are longer than females. Fertilization is internal. Development may be direct. So that is, the young ones will always resemble the adult, or indirect, like larval stage. If the organism have the larval stage, then we call the development as indirect. If directly it develops, then we call it as direct development. Example, Ascaris, roundworm, Wuchereria, filarial worm. So, and Cyclostoma, hookworm. These are mostly parasites. Next, phylum Annelida. Annelida means ring-like structures. So, they may be aquatic, marine or freshwater, or terrestrial, free-living, and sometimes parasitic. They exhibit organ system level of body organization and bilateral symmetry. They are triploblastic, metamerically segmented, and coelomate animals. Their body surface is distinctly marked out into segments or metameres, and hence the final phylum name Annelida means, in Latin we call it as little rings. They possess a longitudinal and circular muscles. They helps in locomotion. Aquatic Annelida like Nereis will possess a lateral appendages, which we call it as parapodia, which helps in swimming. A closed circulatory system is present. Nephridia, in singular we call it as nephridium, helps in osmoregulation and excretion. Neural system consists of a paired ganglia connected by lateral nerves to a double ventral nerve cord. So Nereis is an aquatic form, which is dioecious. But earthworms and leeches are monoecious, means both sexes are. If dioecious means we have separate sexes. Monoecious means the two sexes, hermaphrodite or monoecious. So, reproduction is sexual. Example, Nereis prithima, which is earthworm. Nereis prithima, earthworm, and Hyrunaria, which is blood-sucking leech. So, this is example. Nereis, the first one is Nereis, and the second one is leech, Hyrudinaria. And next phylum, Arthropoda. This is the largest phyla of Animalia. So, Arthropoda is the largest phylum of Animalia, and the second largest phylum is Mollusk, which include insects. Over one third of all named species on earth are arthropods. They have organ system level of organization. They are bilateral symmetric, triploblastic, segmented, and coelomate animals. The body of arthropods is covered by chitinous exoskeleton. So like chitin we have seen in the plant kingdom for mushrooms. Yeah, mushrooms will process the chitin. The body consists of head, thorax, and abdomen. So the segmentation is there. They have jointed appendages. Orthos means joint, poda means appendages. So arthropoda, the name. Respiratory organs are gills, book lungs, or tracheal system. Circulatory system is an open type, because the blood will bath in the, so the organs will bath in the blood directly. Sense organs like antenna, eyes, compound and simple eyes, statocyst or balancing organ are present. Excretion takes place through Malpighian tubules. So here the Malpighian tubules are the excretory organs. When it comes to Annelida, we have to remind the nephridia. So that is the very important excretory organ there. They are mostly dioecious. Fertilization is, if it is dioecious means both sexes are separate. Monoecious means it is both sexes are in the same organism. That is a slight confusion, but we have to remind it. So, book lungs, excretion takes place through Malpighian tubules, and they are mostly dioecious. So, fertilization is usually internal. They are mostly oviparous, means laying eggs. Development may be direct or indirect. In sometimes it is direct, in sometimes it may be indirect in some organisms. Examples, economically important insects are Apis, honeybees, which means Bombyx, silkworm, Lacifer means lac insect. Vectors are Anopheles, Culex, Aedes. These are mosquitoes. Gregarious pest is locust, and living fossil is Limulus, which is king crab. Limulus is a king crab. So these are the examples, and the A first one is locust, and the B butterfly, scorpion, prawn. These are all will comes under arthropoda. and example. So let's see the second largest phylum, which is mollusk. Mollusk means soft. This is the second largest animal phyla. Mollusks are terrestrial or aquatic, marine or freshwater, and have an organ system level of organization. They are bilateral, symmetrical, triploblastic and coelomates. Body is covered by a calcareous shell, and those are unsegmented with distinct head, muscular foot and visceral hump. Hump means that elevation, we call it as hump. A soft and spongy layer of skin forms a mantle over the visceral hump. The space between the hump and the mantle, we call it as mantle cavity, in which the feather-like gills are present. They have a respiratory and excretory functions. The anterior head region has a sensory tentacles. The mouth contains a file-like rasping organ. So file-like rasping organ for feeding, which we call it as radula. Okay. So for mollusk, octopus will comes under mollusk, and for A, this is phyla. So these are the common cells, common shells we see near the beach, phyla. Next, they are usually dioecious and oviparous with indirect development. So the larval stage will be there. Dioecious means they have separate sexes. Example, phyla, which we call it as apple snail. Pink tada, which is pearl oyster, sepia, cuttlefish, lologia, squid, octopus, which is we call it as devilfish, aplysia, sea hare, dentalium, tusk shell, and Chaetoplura, chiton, we call it as. Next phylum is Echinodermata. These animals have a endoskeleton of calcareous ossicles, and hence the name Echinodermata. Okay. Spined body. Derma means skin. So echino means spines. So on the skin they have a spine like projections. That's why we call it as Echinodermata. All are marine with organ system level of organization. The adult echinoderms are radially symmetrical, but larval are bilaterally symmetrical. They are triploblastic and coelomate animals. Presence of coelom. Digestive system is complete with mouth on the lower side and anus on the upper side. So the most distinctive feature of echinoderms is presence of water vascular system, which helps in the locomotion, capture and transport of food and respiration. An excretory system is totally absent. So sexes are separate, reproduction is sexual, fertilization is usually external. Development is indirect with free swimming larva. Species are Astrecia, starfish, Echinus, sea urchin, Antidon, sea lily, Cucurmia, sea cucumber, and Ophiria, brittle star. So this is Astreas, which is starfish, Ophuria, which is brittle star. So this looks like star only. Next, phylum Hemichordata. Hemi means half. Hemichordata are earlierly considered as a subphylum under the phylum Chordata. But now it is placed as a separate phylum under non-chordata. Hemichordata have a rudimentary structure in the collar region, which we call it as stomochord, a structure similar to the notochord. The phylum consists of a small group of worm-like marine animals with organ system level of organization. They are bilaterally symmetrical, triploblastic and coelomate animals. The body is cylindrical and is composed of anterior proboscis, a collar and a long trunk. So the circulatory system is open type. The respiration takes place is through gills. Excretory organ is proboscis gland. Sexes are separate. Fertilization is external. Development is indirect. Means larval stage is present. Balanoglossus and Sacoglossus are the examples for this Hemichordata. And here we have the collar. So because of this collar region, stomachord, because of that only we call it as Hemichordata. And finally, the phylum Chordata. Animals belonging to the phylum Chordata are fundamentally characterized by the presence of notochord, a dorsally hollow nerve tube and paired pharyngeal gill slits. These are the bilateral, symmetrical, triploblastic, coelomate with organ system level of organization. They possess a post-anal tail and a closed circulatory system. So these are the characteristic features of chordata. A present comparison of a silent features between chordata and non-chordata. In this picture, we can see the characteristics. It has the nerve cord, notochord. In notochord, in future, it will develop into vertebra, gill slits for respiration and post-anal tail. So these are present. Coming to the comparison between chordata and non-chordata, in chordata, notochord is present. In non-chordates, notochord is absent. Central nervous system is dorsal, hollow and single in chordates. In non-chordates, the central nervous system is ventral. So normally, the central nervous system should be dorsal, but for non-chordates, the central nervous system is ventral. For example, if you see the annelida also, like earthworm, you can see the nervous system on the front, solid and double. So in chordates, the pharynx perforated by gill slits. In non-chordates, the gill slits are absent. In chordates, heart is ventral, but in non-chordates, the heart is dorsal if present. So that is the quite opposite thing between the central nervous system and heart. You have to notice this. And next, chordates. Post-anal tail is present. Here, the post-anal tail is absent. So phylum chordata is again divided into three subphyla, that is urochordata or tunicochordata. Tunicata means layers. It will be like layers. And cephalochordata and vertebrata. Subphyla urochordata and cephalochordata are often referred to as protochordates. So this is the protochordates, Ascidia, and are exclusively marine. In urochordata, notochord is present only in the larval tail, while in cephalochordata, it extends from head to tail region and disperses throughout the life. Examples for the urochordata: Ascidia, Salpa, Doliolum, cephalochord. So these are the examples for urochordata. For cephalochordata, Brachiostoma, Amphixius, and Lancelet. The membranes of subphylum Vertebrata possess the notochord during the embryonic period. The notochord is replaced by cartilaginous or bony vertebral column in adult. Thus, all vertebrates are chordates, but all chordates are not vertebrates. I think we got the point from here. Beside the basic chordate characters, vertebrates have a ventral muscular heart with 2 or 3 or 4 chambers, kidneys for excretion and osmoregulation, and paired appendages, maybe fins or limbs. So those are the characteristic features of vertebrata. Let's see the division. So subphylum Vertebrata is further divided into, so this is the subphylum Vertebrata, Agnatha and Gnathostomata. Agnatha means lack of jaws. Gnathostomata means presence of jaws. So under Agnatha, we have a class called Cyclostomata. If the jaws is not there, the mouth is circular. So Cyclostomata. Cyclostomata means round opening. And coming to the Gnathostomata, which bears the jaws. So it is again divided into 2 superclasses, that is Pisces and Tetrapoda. Pisces means which bears the fins. So under this, we have a class called Chondroichthyes and Osteoichthyes. So nothing but cartilaginous fish and bony fish. Tetrapoda, which bears the limbs. Amphibia, Reptalia, Aves and Mammals. Let's see the class Cyclostoma. Cyclostomata, which comes under the division of Agnatha, which means lack of jaws. All living members of the class Cyclostomata are ectoparasites on some fishes. They have an elongated body bearing and a pair of gill slits for respiration. Cyclostomes have a sucking and circular mouth without jaws. Their body is devoid of scales, paired fins, cranium and vertebral column are cartilaginous. Circulation is closed type. Cyclostomes are marine but migrate from spawning to freshwater. After spawning, within a few days, they die. Their larva after the metamorphosis will return to the ocean. Example, Petromyzon, which we also called as lamprey. Myxin, which we also called as hagfish. Lamprey and hagfish are very important for Cyclostomata. Next, class Chondroichthyes. So, which will comes under Gnathostomata. So, these are marine animals. which streamlined the body have a cartilaginous endoskeleton. Mouth is located ventrally. Notochord is persistent throughout the life. Gill slits are present but without operculum. The skin is very tough, containing minute placoid scales. The teeth are modified placoid scales which are in backward direction. The jaws are very powerful. These animals are predaceous due to absence of air bladder. So they have to swim constantly to avoid sinking. So examples for the cartilaginous feces, scolidion and pristis. So these are the examples. Heart is two chambered, one auricle and one ventricle. Some of them have electric organs like torpedo, and some possess the poison and stings like trigon. They are cold blooded, means poikilothermic, thermic animals. They always will have a body temperature based on the environment. They lack the capacity to regulate their body temperatures. Sexes are separate. In males, we'll have the pelvic fin and bears the claspers. So with this pelvic fin only, we'll differentiate from male and female. They have internal fertilization and many of them are viviparous. Means it will give birth directly. Like shark will give the birth to directly because of this case. Example, scolidion, which we call it as dogfish. Pristis, sawfish. Carcharodon, great white shark. Trigon, stingray. And next, osteichthyes. It includes both marine and freshwater fishes with bony endoskeleton. Their body is streamlined. Mouth is mostly terminal. They have four pairs of gills, which is covered by operculum on each side. Skin is covered with cycloid or ctenoid scales. Air bladder is present, which regulate the buoyancy. Heart is two-chambered, one auricle and one ventricle. They are cold-blooded animals. Sexes are separate. Fertilization is usually external. They are mostly oviparous and development is direct. Example, the marine are Exocetus, which we call it as flying fish. Hippocampus, seahorse. Freshwater, Labio, which we also call it Rohu, Katla, Clarius, Magar. In the aquarium, Betta means fighting fish. So fighter, we also call it as Betta. Pterophyllum, which is angel fish. And next, class Amphibia. As the name indicates, amphi means dual, bio means life, amphibia. So the amphibia can live in aquatic as well as terrestrial. Most of them have two pairs of limbs. The body is divisible into head and trunk. There is no any neck region. So tail may be present in some. The amphibian skin is moist without scales. The eyes have eyelids. A tympanum which represents the ear. Elementary canal, urinary and reproductive tracts open into a common chamber which we call it as cloaca. So you can see the cloaca in this amphibia which opens to the exterior. Respiration is by gills, lungs and through skin. The heart is three chambered, two auricles and one ventricles. So when it comes to fishes we have two chambered. When it comes to amphibians we have three chambered. They are cold blooded animals. Sexes are separate. Fertilization is external because the frog lay the eggs in the damp or in the water only. So they are oviparous and development is indirect. Example, Bufo, which means toad. Rana means frog. Hyla, tree frog. Salamander. Ichthyopius, limbless amphibia. So examples of amphibia. Here the first A, this is salamander. And the second one, Rana, which means frog. And the next coming class is Reptalia. The class name refers to their creeping and crawling mode of locomotion, Reptalia. In Latin, rapere or reptum means creep or crawl. They are mostly terrestrial animals, means land living. Their body is covered with dry, cornified skin, epidermal scales or scutes. They do not have external ear openings. Tympanum will represent the ear. Limbs, when present, they are of two pairs. Heart is usually three-chambered, but four-chambered heart is present in crocodiles. This is very, very important question. For crocodiles, it is four-chambered heart. Reptiles are poikilotherms. Snakes and lizards shed their scales at a skin cast. Sexes are separate. Fertilization is internal. They are oviparous and development is direct. Examples, next, Chelon, turtle, tortoise, tree lizard, chameleon, and crocodile, alligator, wall lizard, Naza, poisonous snakes, pangaris, krite, vipera means viper. So these are all will comes under reptiles. And next, class aves. The characteristic feature of aves is presence of feathers, and the most of them can fly except the flightless birds, ostrich. Like we have some of the examples also. They possess the beak. The forelimbs are modified into wings. The hind limbs generally have scales that are modified for walking, swimming and claspers. Clasping the tree branches. Skin is dry without glands except the oil glands at the base of the tail. The endoskeleton is fully ossified and the long bones are hollow with air cavities. Like fishes will have the air bladder to swim. Here the aves will have air cavities to fly, which are pneumatic, means filled with air. The digestive tract of the birds have additional chamber, which we call it as crop or gizzard. Crop and gizzard. The heart is completely four-chambered. They are warm-blooded, means homeothermic, means they can control their body temperature. They can able to maintain the constant body temperature. So here we have the examples, some of the birds: neophron, strutev, ostrich, next parrot. We have the pavo, which means peacock. Air sacs connect to the lungs, supplement the respiration. Sexes are separate. Fertilization is internal. They are oviparous. Development is direct. There is no any larval stage. We have the crow, pigeon, parrot, peacock, ostrich, penguin and vulture. And finally, we came to the class mammalia. They are found in a variety of habitats: polar ice caps, deserts, mountains, forest, grassland and dark caves. Some of them have adapted to fly or live in water. The most unique mammalian character is presence of milk producing gland, which is the mammary gland. So because of that, mammalia, ma means mom, from which the young ones are nourished. They have two pairs of limbs adapted for walking, running, climbing, burrowing, swimming or flying. So these are the mammals. So mammals have a unique in the possessing of hair. External ears or pinna are present. The different types of teeth are present in the jaw. Heart is four-chambered. They are homeothermous, means we can maintain our own body temperature. So respiration is by lungs. Sexes are separate. The fertilization is internal. They are viviparous with few exceptions, and development is direct. So like duck-billed platypus is oviparous, but it comes under mammalia. That is an exception. Oviparous. Ornithorhynchus, which is platypus, duck-billed platypus, which is oviparous. Viviparous are macropus, which is kangaroo, flying fox, camelus, camel, macaca, monkey, rattus, rat, canis, dog, felis, cat, eliphas, means elephant, equus, horse, delphinus, means common dolphin, balaenoptera, which means blue whale, panthera, tigris, tiger, and Panthera leo, lion. So let's see the common silent features of animal kingdom. So this is the classification of animal kingdom. Let's see once again. So we have the columns and rows and columns. Let's see the columns. We have the phylum, level of organization, symmetry, coelom, segmentation, digestive system, circulatory system, respiratory system, and distinctive features, means special features. Let's see for the phylum Porifera. Level of organization is cellular. Symmetry is various symmetry. So mostly asymmetrical. Coelom is absent. So Porifera, which is very old, archy, because of that, coelom will not be there. Segmentation is absent. Digestive system is absent. Circulatory system is absent. Respiratory system is also absent. So very distinctive feature is body is with pores and canals in the wall. Next, coelentrata. So the level of organization is tissue and the symmetry is radial and the coelom is absent. So we have the segmentation is also absent. Digestive system is incomplete. Circulatory system is also absent. Respiratory system is also absent. So the distinctive feature is nidoblast, presence of nidoblast. So because of that, we call it as cnidarians. Next, Ctenophora. The tissue level of organization, radial symmetry, coelom is absent, segmentation is absent, digestive system is incomplete, circulatory system and respiratory system both are absent, and distinctive feature is comb plates for locomotion. Because of that, we call it as stenophora. Next, platyhelminthes, organ and organ system, bilateral symmetry, coelom is absent, segmentation is absent, digestion is incomplete, both circulatory and respiratory systems are absent, flat body and suckers, that is the distinctive features, because most are parasites. Next, asclementhes, so the tissue organ system level of organization, bilateral symmetry, pseudocoelomate, absent of segmentation, complete digestive system, absent of circulatory and respiratory system, often worm shaped and elongated. Next, annelida, organ system level of organization, bilateral symmetry, coelomate, segmentation is present and digestive system is complete. So we have the circulatory system is present and respiratory system is absent. The body segmentation will be like rings. Next, arthropoda. Arthropoda, we have the organ system level of organization, bilateral symmetry, coelomates, so presence of segmentation and complete digestive system and respiratory system, circulatory and respiratory system are present. So we have the exoskeleton is made up of cuticle, jointed appendages are present. Mollusk, organ system level of organization, bilateral symmetry, coelomates, so absent of segmentation, and we have the complete digestive system and circulatory and respiratory system are present. External exoskeleton of shell is usually present. Next, echinoderms. Echinoderms, and mostly these both are looking common, echinoderms and hemichordata both have the organ system level of organization. Echinoderms is having radial symmetry, hemichordata is bilateral symmetry, and both are coelomates. For both, there is an absence of segmentation, the digestive system is complete, and present of both will have the circulatory and respiratory system. For echinoderms, water vascular system and radial symmetry is distinctive features. For hemichordata, worm like with proboscis, collar and trunk. Next, finally, chordata, organ system level of organization, bilateral symmetry, coelomates, and we have the presence of digestive system, complete digestive system is complete, segmentation is present, and presence of circulatory and respiratory system, which is higher level. Notochord, dorsal hollow nerve cord, gill slits with limbs and fins. So these are all about the kingdom Animalia. Okay, my dear friends, thank you very much. So please follow my video with patience. So line to line, it will make your further study a bit easy. If you are thorough with the chapter and if you watch this video at once, you will get into the topic very easily. Thank you very much. If you like my video, like it, share to your friends and comment if any feedback is there. Thank you very much.